It's official. Boom Supersonic's first aircraft, the XB-1, had its first flight on March 22, 2024. The jet is a test vehicle for building Overture, the first supersonic commercial airliner since Concorde. Let's examine this major developmental step for today's video. According to Boom Supersonic, the XB-1, which carries registration November 990 X-ray Bravo, met all of its test objectives in its first flight. This initial test only saw the aircraft 7,120 feet above sea level and fly at a top speed of 238 knots or 274 miles per hour. Unfortunately, it was nowhere near supersonic, but this will come with future flights. The first flight of XB-1 took place at the Mojave Air and Spaceport in California and was flown by Boom Chief Test Pilot Bill Doc Shoemaker. Shoemaker is a former U.S. Navy pilot and shared the following statement on this major accomplishment. "Everyone on the XB-1 team should be incredibly proud of this achievement. It has been a privilege to share this journey with so many dedicated and talented professionals. The experience we've gained in reaching this milestone will be invaluable to Boom's revival of supersonic travel." Boom's CEO explains that the XB-1 is intended to help Boom Supersonic learn how to build supersonic aircraft, learning technical lessons about how to design and optimize such an aircraft, from aerodynamics to propulsion to systems integration. According to Boom, the XB-1 will be testing, among other things, an augmented reality vision system, digitally optimized aerodynamics, carbon fiber composites, and supersonic intakes. In light of recent events at Boeing, safety culture was highlighted as a priority in the testing and development of Boom aircraft. Boom's CEO stated, "We wanted to build a safety culture from the ground up, and we also wanted to learn how you run an airplane program." Scholl wants Boom Supersonic to be an organization where problems are openly discussed and resolved. "Every workday, the organization starts by checking in to see if there are any safety or quality concerns." Additionally, Scholl has learned from Boeing's troubles with safety culture, sharing how one can have a world-class safety culture but end up breaking it. "Broken safety culture is really hard to rebuild," he says. Scholl reminded Simple Flying that Boom Supersonic is partnering with the U.S. Air Force to develop supersonic transports so that diplomatic connections and insertions of special forces can be made to reduce the risk of global turmoil. At the same time, Scholl indicated Boom Supersonic had no interest in its aircraft becoming a weapons platform at this time. What do you think of this progress? Does it leave you feeling more optimistic that Boom will actually develop the next Concorde-type aircraft? Let us know by leaving a comment. In addition to our daily YouTube videos, Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.